Hi, this is Mike Sayers. I'm going to show a little video explaining what VS commands are, the scripting language that's available in CarSim, TruckSim, BikeSim, and SuspensionSim. We're using VS commands in this example here to add some features that don't already exist in TruckSim, namely to go up a road whose grade is adjusted dynamically to different intervals. This is not built in, so we'll see how we add it. Before diving into VS commands, be aware that there is documentation about how they work. In the reference manuals, there's the VS commands reference manual, which is about 80 pages, and there's a summary, which is just 2 pages, intended to be a cheat sheet. As a cheat sheet, this really isn't enough to master VS commands if you've never been exposed to them, but once you know that some example exists, it's a handy reference. Now we'll take a look at how we extended this model. Up here on the Run Control screen, we have the vehicle, the procedure, and here's a link to something called VS Commands. So we'll go look at that, and these are the commands. Now another way to see them is in the echo file. For example, the first command up here is define units. Here in the echo file, that's shown. And this is because we want to use units of percent for some of the parameters that we're going to put in. If we go to the end of the echo file, we'll see the VS commands, any new variables that were defined. We see that there are 3 parameters that were added, 2 output variables, and 3 equations that went in. Over here is where they were specified. Here are the 3 parameters, here are the 2 outputs, here's our command to add percentage units, and you see we use the percent here for the grade increment, and we also used it for one of the output variables here, the road grade. So when we look at plots, we'll see that the road grade is shown as a percentage instead of as a dimensionless ratio. Now a key in this example is that we use these new parameters and output variables to put some equations in here that make use of some imports that all exist in CarSim and TruckSim that give an acceleration field we use to mimic gravity. Instead of the truck going up the hill, it's going on level, but the gravity vector is tilted so that the load transfers and engine power requirements are the same as if it were going up a hill. Now recall from the example that the grade of the road wasn't constant, it changed dynamically. You see at the speed up here that once we reach a target speed, the grade would magically increase. As long as we would reach the speed, it would increase. But when we fail to reach the speed on this last one, the run ends. The readjustment of parameters are done with events, with data sets from this screen, the event screen. When we look at this, we see that there are some parameters that might be set here. We're incrementing the grade. And then down here is a new pending event, which is saying that when our local time is greater than some time interval here, then the event should be triggered. And when this happens, the solver will read this parse file and do what it says. It's not going to change anything up here, but it adds 2 more pending events. One is to check the speed. If the speed target and the actual vehicle speed are within a tolerance, then we're good, and it will go and repeat what we did before. It'll change the grade. Otherwise, it will keep waiting and waiting, and when the local time reaches an interval, which T wait we say up here was set for 20 seconds, then that will end the run. We'll take a look at the log file here to see how those events triggered. And we see that after the run starts, we have a condition, we're checking the speed, we're setting a new grade, checking the speed, setting a new grade, and we keep going until it fails. Going back to our cheat sheet here, these are some of the operators that we used in those Boolean expressions that were in the events. We used some of the functions in here, like the sine and cosine operators when we were checking, when we were adding equations. We defined parameters and outputs. We used the event screen to do the events, and we added equations down here at the beginning of each time step. If there's any doubt about where the equations go in, we have a little timeline here that gives you a reference of where the new equations go relative to other equations in the model. Well, that's an introduction to VS commands. Thank you for watching.